I became interested in using radio so my friends and I could talk instantly throughout our area, even in times of emergency. I also thought it would be handy to have extended range communications on an outing like a group camping trip, horseback trail ride, or other event. This would be great for both organization and safety. For maximum reach, I started looking for repeater options, which range from a very expensive multi-component unit for thousands of dollars down to a small box that took the speaker output from one handheld and fed it into the mic input of another. After some research, I found a purpose-built all-in-one unit that was just about perfect and reasonably affordable. The Retivas RT97 is a 10-watt FCC type-approved all-in-one unit and can be purchased configured for VHF, UHF, or GMRS. It stores 10 frequency sets, including tone codes, and can be programmed from a PC with supplied software and cables. Your operating frequency choice is set and shown on a display panel. It came with an AC power pack so it could run on house power, but I'd either have to run an extension cord outside to power it or run the antenna cable back inside the house to reach it. Since I'm reasonably experienced with solar generators, I figured I could pretty easily make it solar powered and completely self-contained. With a few measurements, 12 volt power, 100 milliamp idle current, and 1.1 amps for transmit, I was able to work out the math and determine the components I'd need. I also built some test gear to validate my calculations and ran the setup cobbled together for about 2 months. In the end, a pair of 9 amp hour batteries with a 20 watt solar panel and charge controller produced a full recharge in under 4 hours and a 2-day reserve to carry through inclement weather. As I envisioned the unit in use, I thought tapping into the 12 volt system to power other devices could add to its utility. So I added 2 Anderson power pole connectors and 2 USB-C power ports to the design. After a little fine-tuning, I knew what components I needed to house in the final unit, so I started looking for an adequate weatherproof case and worked out the mechanical design. I found an excellent choice in volume, sturdiness, and weather resistance in a military surplus 40mm ammo can. I put a port for the solar panel and a connector for the antenna into the can using RTV silicone to make sure they were watertight and to prevent them from shaking loose from vibration. To support the control panel, I fastened lengths of aluminum angle bracket to the inside just below the top edge. Then I drilled and tapped 6 screw holes that will later hold the panel. I built several harnesses, all equipped with connectors for flexibility of configuration. I used SAE connectors for the solar side and Anderson power pole connectors for the 12 volt side and for the repeater. The two types make it harder to connect things up improperly, and there's a lot of flexibility for easy design changes. I wanted the unit to be self-contained and fully portable, and robust enough that it wouldn't be damaged if it wasn't always upright when moved or transported, or if someone was less than gentle handling it. For this, the internal components needed to be held in place, but I wanted to minimize the number of holes I'd be putting in the case, so I decided on an internal frame that would brace components, holding them to the walls of the box. I fashioned a frame from aluminum bar stock, holding it first with screws and then later with pop rivets. I then placed the repeater and batteries into the case using the frame to lock everything in place. The charge controller needs to shed heat, and normally putting it inside a sealed box might be a problem. In this case, I mounted it to the exterior wall with heatsink compound. This will transfer the heat to the steel case itself. This effectively increases the size of the heatsink and radiates heat outside the case. I needed to drill holes for this, so I coated the screw heads with RTV before inserting them, then used a trick I learned to clean up the mess. Before touching anything, spray it all with 409 cleaner. Use a piece of paper towel, also wet with 409, to wipe around the screw heads following around their contour. The 409 will prevent the RTV from smearing onto the wire area of the box, leaving nothing to clean up afterward. It doesn't show so well in the picture, but the screw heads are shiny and the bead of black silicone is perfect. After mounting the charge controller, I installed a short patch cord for the antenna and connected the power cable for the repeater. Then I added the battery harness. Then I started designing the top panel. I was looking for something that would give it a finished look and provide status information so the health of the unit could be monitored and managed. I cut the panel from acetyl plastic. It looks good, is easy to work with, resistant to chemicals and abrasion, and is reasonably sturdy. After cutting all the necessary holes, I began to fine trim them to closely fit the components. Using a file or rasp was nearly useless because abrading away unwanted material was next to impossible. However, carving the edge down with a knife was super easy and made really nice edges. I included a digital power meter to show voltage, current, and power from the solar panel into the system. Then I added a 12-volt system consisting of the Anderson power pole connectors, the USB power ports with digital voltmeter, and a digital battery monitor. The battery monitor is very important because running the batteries down below 50% causes damage that cuts the number of charging cycles they'll handle before being seriously degraded. I don't want to have to do this by translating voltages in my head, so having a meter that directly shows battery charge is the answer. Finally, I added a switch to power the repeater. Without it, the repeater will always be powered by the batteries, and there are lots of reasons why this isn't ideal. You'd want the repeater to be cold when you're connecting and disconnecting the antenna. You'd also like to transport a fully charged unit to a remote location and not have the power depleted by a running repeater by the time it arrived. When I first built the unit, I'd not yet realized the need for the repeater power switch. When I decided to include it later, I wired it with a pigtail that had two connectors. Adding it was as simple as drilling the hole to hold it and plugging the connectors between a previous connection. I mounted and wired everything on the panel using connectors on it all. After cleaning it with alcohol, I used RTV liberally to lock everything in place and to provide some strain relief for the wires. With RTV, nothing will ever shake loose, but the silicone can be cut with a sharp knife then peeled off should there be a need to replace a component. After connecting the harness and components together, I could lay in the control panel, then hold it down with thumb screws. I added some labels to make it easier for people to use and to give it a more finished look. The control panel has power monitoring meter for the solar charging system. It shows the solar panel voltage, the current flowing into the system, the instantaneous power entering the system, and the accumulated watt hours put in. The 12-volt system has two Anderson power pole connectors to support other equipment, two USB 3.0 power ports to charge devices, and a battery monitor which shows percentage of charge and battery voltage. Below that is a lighted push-button switch that controls power to the repeater itself. With this, the operator can turn off the repeater to facilitate antenna connection and disconnection, or to conserve battery power during transport. The repeater now lives outdoors, connected to the solar panel and to its antenna. It's secured with a lock and cable for security. Including the $400 cost of the repeater itself, the entire project cost just over $700. I couldn't find anything comparable in features and capability anywhere on the market. The closest I could find was the same repeater unit, a small solar generator, an added solar panel, and a weatherproof cabinet, which would cost more and be less capable. If you'd like to build your own unit, I posted a complete parts list and wiring diagram at www.desertprep.info. Perhaps my research and design work will save you time and money. I hope you'll be inspired to make your own version of this using my design or incorporating your creativity and knowledge in a modified version that makes something quite different and ideal for your own situation. So what do you think? I'd be delighted to have your feedback and suggestions in the comments below. I've learned a great deal from the encouragement, suggestions, and criticisms people leave for me, and my projects are much better for it. For all of it, I'm grateful. Don't forget to like the video so it'll be shown to other people that are interested in this kind of thing. Wishing you health and happiness. See you next time.